Hi, my name's Ed. Welcome to Ed Explains English, Life in the UK.
Was that a yawn I saw there, Ed?
Just a little one. It was a late night, but I had to watch the big match.
Even though you knew we were visiting the Tate Modern Museum in London today?
I wasn't to know that the match would go to extra time, then penalties. It was exciting, though.
Let's go to the kitchen and bar restaurant and drink a cup of coffee to wake you up.
Good idea. We'll get a great view of the capital too.
That's true. Maybe you'll show more interest in the buildings than you did the paintings and exhibits.
To be honest, Judy, I'm not the biggest fan of modern art.
Is it because there are no paintings of men in colourful shirts kicking a piece of leather around?
I prefer the paintings at the National Gallery. I can see what I'm looking at, and I don't have to interpret what the painters wanted to express.
You could be right. Nevertheless, it's so wonderful that we have so many museums which we can visit, free of charge, on our doorstep too.
I always give a donation though. The upkeep on these places must be high. London is truly one of the capitals of culture in the world.
What does culture really mean to you, Ed?
For me, culture is the knowledge and characteristics of groups of people, in our case British, which include language, art, literature, music, food, religion, and dare I say it, sport.
There is nothing cultural about sport, especially when I think of the big hairy rugby players throwing a funny shaped ball around. But I agree with you on the other points.
I don't think something has to be hundreds of years old to be considered cultural either. The Beatles, Ed Sheeran and Adele, for example, are equally as important as Elgar and Holst.
Using that logic, the street artist Banksy should be held in high regard, like Constable and Turner.
That's right, Judy. Culture is of its period and of the past too. I'd like to think that people will be singing "We all live in a yellow submarine" in 200 years' time.
With all the talk of global warming, people might be living in yellow submarines in 2221. Have you finished your coffee? We can go and see some contemporary art in the Turbine Hall.
Oh, great. I can't get enough of seeing unmade beds and piles of magazines on the floor. We could have seen that by looking in the kids' room at home.
We would like to thank you for watching this video. Visit Instagram, where you can find complimentary vocabulary for this and our other videos. Please like, comment and share this video with your friends, as well as subscribing. Thanks for watching. Toodle-pip!